Welcome to a brand new episode on Daily Life. Today we are covering the Captain's Boil. It's a seafood place. Let's go inside the restaurant. The food is here.
Oh my god, I'm so cheesy.
So what did you get here?
There's some clams, mussels, crawfish, shrimp, some fried shrimp, I guess.
And what is the rice you have there?
Just rice with corn. I don't know what this is. Just rice with corn and onions with some teriyaki sauce.
Is this your first time here?
Come here a lot.
What do you think about the food that you usually get?
I love it. And this is a lunch special. So
you don't come here at lunchtime, or you want...
Usually for dinner.
Dinner?
But
okay.
It looks really good.
Alright.
Because you get a big assortment of what they have to offer.
Okay, makes sense. Makes sense. So what was the name of the dish that you have in front of you?
This one is seafood platter.
Okay, and the price?
It was $13.99.
Okay. That's good.
Oh, and this is the Captain's Boil sauce, but I didn't get any spice on it.
What was the spice level you got?
Non-spicy.
Non-spicy,
last
okay.
Time I got medium and it was pretty spicy for me, so I tuned it down a bit.
So should people be cautious when they come here for the spice level, or should they
for the maximum spice level? Yeah, but if you want mild, mild's probably good.
Mild is the best, if you can get the taste of the food?
It depends how your spice tolerance is, but I would probably go for mild, because medium was spicy, it was a little too spicy, not enjoyable for me, so.
Makes sense.
Let's dig into the food.
And fries?
Yep.
There you go.
Thank you so much.
Nice, enjoy.
Excellent. And this is the fries.
I came with two of my good friends. One friend you see in the video, and the other friend does not want to be in the video today. Just wants to enjoy the food.
These fries are good.
Yeah. All right. Can you tell me how is the fries?
Good. They have a little spice to them. It's crunchy on the outside, soft on the inside, and the spice is
mild.
Yeah, mild.
And they have the pepper sprinkled on top. And they have ketchup served on top. And the presentation not bad actually. They have a basket at the bottom.
So it's like
chased on my plate. This is the view.
It's on both sides now.
Okay, that's the tissue. Let's see. Oh, there's a lot of chicken that comes with it.
Yeah. It's actually worth the rent.
Yeah, and there's a lot of this. Because usually when I come for night, I only get shrimp. Because you get a pound of it. But it's a good amount. I think like it could feed three, because the sailor's platter is $27.99. It comes with a pound of shrimp, mussels, or you have to choose between them. Then it comes with fries. And it also comes with rice. And the rice is really big. It's like probably like the size of this.
Okay.
It's enough for three people. So split it with three people, it'd be less than $10 each.
Yeah.
The restaurant got more busy.
So after taking one bite of the rice, what do you think about the rice?
It's pretty standard, but the sauce makes it better.
So you need to have the sauce on top to get the flavor and stuff.
You mix it with the captain boil sauce.
Uh-huh.
It's like this little reddish sauce.
Okay.
It tastes a lot better.
It's a lot better with the reddish sauce, I think.
Yeah. But like, in order to get at these, we gotta put on the gloves.
Oh yeah, there's gloves, and there you get this, and the gloves also come with it, so it doesn't get your hands dirty.
Yeah, and then there's like a bucket where you can put all the shells. But this is chicken, yeah. So the kitchen ran out of fish, so then we had to get chicken instead. It's a seafood place, so I'd prefer to get the fish, but I'll try the fish too.
Then the chicken too.
The chicken was okay, it's pretty standard. But you come here for the seafood.
This is not the time.
Now we will show you how to peel the shrimp.
So to peel the shrimp, I usually just take off the head.
In the bucket.
Bucket right there.
Alright. And just... It takes a bit longer than usual.
If you're like here for the first time, it may take you forever, but don't be embarrassed, it's okay.
Yeah.
Everybody's gonna learn, so... I may be sucking at this too, I don't know.
You just go segment by segment.
Yeah, the waiter here is really friendly. They're serving on water and asking you like, what do you need in more.
Head, then the fingers, the head, then the body, the biceps, and then the neck, the tail, you can call it tail too. That has to be like side to side, left side and right side, and hopefully it comes in one piece. Or else, like, how you peel it, but that's the easiest way. He has been coming here for more than a year, so he knows how to peel a shrimp. If you don't trust him, then I don't know why you trust him.
It was recommended by him, so trying for the first time here. There's people outside, like looking at the menu, you can see. Yeah, they're really interested in the menu. Do you usually like peel all of them first, or do you just put it in your mouth after you peel one?
You want to eat it right away because it's gonna get cold.
Okay.
So I'd recommend to eat it as soon as you can.
So the pro is saying that you should eat it.
Yeah.
Like you peel it and you put it in your mouth, don't wait.
But make sure you get the sauce. So
this is how we do it. Then come here and try it your own way, and then let us know. We're recommending the platter, but take it at your own risk. According to us, the platter is really worth it for the price that you're getting at. From Yep. Big pieces. And the gloves, you need the gloves. See, it's so dirty. Thanks to them for providing the gloves.
Everyone else here is wearing it, so I don't feel too bad.
No. So you peel the shrimp, you put it in the mouth, take your gloves off, and then eat it with a spoon, rice and whatever you want to eat, and then put it back on.
Crawfish?
Crawfish?
It's like a small version of a lobster.
Okay. And how do you peel that?
So, you just rip the tail off.
Uh-huh.
The tail should have the most meat.
So the tail has the most meat here? So peel that off first?
Yeah.
Make sure you put it in the basket. Don't throw it on the table or somewhere else.
In the provided receptacle. Okay, the tail's almost done.
So this fish doesn't take that long to peel compared to the shrimp.
Yeah. Felt the same for a long time. Oh yeah, if you ever had lobster, this is like a tiny lobster.
Is there any meat in there, or are you just playing around here?
No. There's not a lot of meat, just the head.
Is there any option that you can substitute this fish for the shrimp?
No, not for this.
Not for the platter,
no.
The offer platter. Alright, so now we're gonna eat food and then we're gonna be back after that.
Enjoy the short time lapse of us eating the food. Both of us destroyed the platter, now it's all gone.
I prefer $28 because it comes with a pound of shrimp and I like the shrimp the most. Like, I found that the crawfish was kind of hard to eat because there's not as much meat on it. And the other stuff, like the clams and the mussels, are okay too, but I just like the shrimp the best. Yeah, I do, because then you get to try every type. So it's a good thing that you can try the crawfish, because I was always curious about the crawfish. You try the shrimp, mussels, clams, try it all for $13. So then,
say, what if like people come, right? As a group of four or five, whatever, three. What platter should they get?
If it's three, I think the first platter, sailors, I think it's like sailors platter, can feed three.
So we destroyed the fries and everything else.
Because for the shrimp, if you like the shrimp, platter comes with like 15 shrimp. So
15 shrimps?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
A lot.
That's a lot.
The bowl of rice is huge, definitely enough for three people. And then it comes with fries, so it's good.
Yeah, there's more people around in the restaurant today. It's like packed. Okay, so what I thought of the platter was that the shrimp was really good. Like, the quantity of the shrimp was low. We should have given more shrimp. The crawfish was like a business trick. Like, actually the crawfish does not have any meat inside. You break it and then you cry. I was about to cry, like, this joke. It was good with the teriyaki, this blackish, you can see the blackish brown sauce made it way better. I think the rice does not go with the platter, I think so. They should have given it to us on the side, if they want it, you can have it. Or substitute with fries, if they had the option. But the shrimp and chicken was really good. It was tender, it had a lot of flavor in it. And the rice and the chicken went together, but the shrimp didn't go well with the platter, I think so. But it was worth the price that you're paying. But as my friend behind the camera said, the $28 platter was worth it. If you come with a friend, you're paying less than $10. If you can do the math in your head, it's less than $10, so it's really worth it. So I think the platter was okay. Like, say one person gets the big platter, and one person gets, like, if you're bringing a kid here, the kid got the small platter that we got for, like, adult size was good. The food quality was good, but the crawfish and thing didn't go well together. So I think, yeah, you can try this, but try at own risk. I liked it. My rating out of 10 would be like 8.5, I say, because the crawfish has no meat inside it. And just for the sauce and the chicken, I give it a 8. And the half is for the, like, the rice quantity. So I think you can try it for $14. Yeah, come here, try it, let us know down in the comment section. Thank you.
Last time I came here, I got the sailor platter, which I really liked. I saw that this one was for like $13.99, and you got all the other options, so I wanted to try it. But after trying it, I think that the sailor's one is way better. Like, you get way more food, and there's a lot of shrimp, like enough for 3 people.
We finished our food, this is the bill, now we're gonna head to a bubble tea place.
So guys, after we finished eating our food, the seafood platter, then we went to get a drink. It's the, like a coffee tea mix. This is the place named Tiger Sugar. The place is in downtown Toronto. It is a small place, it's really crowded. There is space to like stand and drink, but I don't think you will ever get a chance. If you do, let me know in the comment down below. The name of the drink is on the receipt. It's too long for me to say it, so just the name. And I spent, before tax, $6.50. Tax was 85 cents and it was $7.35 after tax. So and my friend got the same drink. Difference is you can see the thin tapioca at the bottom, and mine got a lot. The thick ones, so like according to me, after drinking the thick ones, I think the thin ones would be better for me. But I was like, the restaurant was so crowded that I just went with whatever was on the first option of that section of the menu. So I got the thick ones, but this time if I go back, I'll get the thin ones, and I recommend you guys should get the thin ones if you don't like the aftertaste of the tapioca. And this one is like cream at the top with ice, and this is the milk tea at the bottom. There's also options to get without the milk, and you can have it hot and or cold. I have the cold one on my hand. This is really tasty. And if you're really like a health conscious, then there's options to get only black tea. And like my friend's girlfriend tried it before, she doesn't like strong tea, so she didn't recommend it to me. So go with your own risk. I like this one, I'm gonna recommend it, but like it's my personal taste, but same that. So from both of us, we say go with thin tapioca, same drink. And I think you should go there, and the rating, I think it should be like 7 out of 10 for the drink. It's really good. I'm gonna drink it here. You can watch me drink. It's really good. And I'd like to thank my friend for filming the video and letting me put him in the video too. That's it for today. You guys can have a good day. And please make sure to go and subscribe to my friend, link in the description. And also like the video. And share the video and subscribe. Thank you, and see you next video.